Hi, this is Chrisferb, and I'm going to go over a sampling distribution example using a proportion. Okay, so here's the problem. A population has a proportion equal to 0.30. Now, this is essentially our population known proportion. So this is similar to when we're doing hypothesis testing or a regular sampling distribution problems where we have either a statistic or a parameter, meaning a population figure. So this is our population figure. Calculate the probability of our p-hat, which is our sample proportion, being greater than 0.40 with an n equal to 100. Okay, so let's write down what we know. We know that our population parameter is 0.30. We're looking for the p-hat, but our p-hat in this one is 0.40, and then our n is 100. So people say that sometimes proportion examples or calculations and statistics are easier than other regular ones using standard deviations and things like that. So I'll let you be the judge on that. Okay. So let's do the, I'll write down what formula we're going to use, z. And then we have p hat, which is our sample proportion, subtract population proportion. I'll go kind of quick on some of this because I already have it calculated out anyway. So we have the population p, 1 minus population p, which in the binomial calculations, we would call that the Q, or the opposite of success, kind of the failure, and then the N, okay? So we worked this out. We have 0.40 subtract 0.30, and then we go and we have 0.30, put parentheses just to show we're, it's not the same thing, but we're multiplying 0.70, and then 100. And then we work this out and we end up getting 2.1834. We could go on forever, but my Z table only goes out 2 decimal places. So for our example, 2.18 is a good answer for what we're looking for. So this is our Z score. Right there. And now we're going to go down and we're going to find the area on the table, which is the area under the curve. And that is, so 2.18, right there, 0.4854. And I'm going to draw a diagram to kind of show you where this is all going. Okay. In the middle, we always go with it. In this case, I'm putting the population parameter down as our landmark. So we're going to say our population parameter right here is 0.30. And then we need to figure out kind of what we're working with. Our problem says our sample proportion greater than 0.40. So as we go further along to the right, the number increases. So I'm going to put 0.40 right here. And then we're going to figure out, so greater than, so if this is greater than, then our area of interest, if we're doing rejection type of calculations, I'd call this the rejection zone. But in this case, I call it the area of interest, which is what I'm shading. It's right here. Okay, so this is our area of interest. We're trying to find the probability of this area, which is greater than 0.40. Okay. So a couple things here that may be obvious to you, but I'm going to point it out once again. Each side is always 0.5, right? Because all of the probability has to equal 1. I hope you agree with me, because that's kind of just the way it is. Okay, so this whole side's 0.5, this whole side's 0.5, and then we have this number right here. Well, this number, whenever we pull a probability from the table, and it's a alternative table, but the probability that I ended up calculating here, 0.4854, it's always in the center area, it's not in the tail. So we pull this down. So this is our 0.4854. And so I hope you see where we're going with this. If this is 0.4854, and we're trying to find this area, and we know the whole thing over here on this side is 0.5, then we're going to take 0.5, subtract 0.4854, and we end up getting 0.0146, or written as a percentage, it would be 1.46%. So that would be the probability of getting a proportion greater than 0.40. So now let's do this on the calculator. On the calculator, we use a function called the one prop z-test, and that's in stats. Then we go to the right twice, and then we go down to one prop z-test and hit enter. I already have the data in here. So it's not quite intuitive as some of the interfaces on the TI-84. So we put in the population proportion parameter, 0.3. That, of course, is right here, 0.3. And then we put in this case, we're not putting in 0.40, we're putting in the actual number of success. So if we're looking for the number of success of the proportion of 0.40 in 100 actual samples, the assumption is it would be 40. So it's, don't put in the decimal point, don't put in the proportion. As you can see, it's looking for X. So what you can do if you're unsure about that is what you do is you do this. 0.4 times, and then it's that proportion out of 100. And it just puts in there 40. So of course that's obvious, but that's how you can do it too. And then N is 100. And then as we go down, you're looking for whether we're testing for it like a two-tail test or the one-tail test. In this case, we're looking for greater than the population parameter. So do the greater than. Now in this case, it matches our sign. So in some of the tests, when we're working with hypothesis testing, this is the direction of our alternative hypothesis inequality. In this case, it's not. So don't confuse that part. And then we go down to calculate. And what's nice is we get the same answer. Now, there's always rounding involved in our calculations by hand, and this table only goes out to two places. So there's always a little bit of lack of precision when we do it by hand versus the calculator. I'm guessing the calculator is slightly more precise. I would assume that. But what this does is it shows the proportion. It says proportion greater than 0.30. It's the inequality of what we're looking for. And then it shows the Z. So the Z is what we've been using. And then the P, now this is actually our answer, 0.0145. And we calculated 0.0146. So we're close enough. Okay, thank you for watching.